Hey guys, assalamu alaikum, it's me Talha. In this video I will be sharing with you a Revit material hack to override the materials quickly and easily in Revit. Before I get started, I would like to let you know about my website learnrevitonline.com, where you can get my Revit online courses. You can follow the first link in the description. Now let's get started. So here I'm in Revit, and as you can see, I have already opened this project which I did some time ago on my channel. If you want to watch this tutorial, you can check out the link in the description. Anyway, what I noticed was to override the materials, people usually use phasing to override the material. But the problem with this method is that it will override each and every single element in your project, and you cannot keep the transparent or the glass materials. You will have to override them as well, or at least you will have to hide them in your project. So the method which I learned recently allows you to override the materials, as well as you can keep the glass materials in your project. So the trick is, we are going to export our project into a CAD format and then just re-import it again into Revit, and it will allow you to override the materials easily, as well as you will be able to keep the transparent materials in your project. So let's do that. Just go to File, Export, CAD Formats, and here I'll select DWG. Just leave everything as it is, then click Next. And here you can select the file. If you're using an earlier version of Revit, you can choose AutoCAD 2010 or 2007 version. I'm using Revit 2022, so I will use AutoCAD 2018. And then the rest we can just leave it like that and click OK. So the file is now exported. Let's create a new project and import that AutoCAD file. I will select Imperial Architectural Template, click OK. Now let's import that project. Just go to Insert, Import CAD, select the file, and if you want to load it on the same origin, you can just choose from here. Since we want to use it for the rendering, I would like to use this one, center to center, then click Open. And the project file is now loaded. Let's go to 3D. Perfect. Now to override the material, we need to go to Manage, Object Styles, and then Imported Objects. And here you'll find all the drawings loaded into the project. Right now we only have one which we have just loaded. So let's click this plus icon, and here you'll find all the layers in the project. But you only need to focus on a few of these, such as door frame, and we have glazing material here. You will understand which material you need to override by the names mentioned here. Now let's override the material for the doors first. We have a ceiling material here as well, but I don't think the ceiling will be visible, so I will override the door material first. Let's click at the corner here, and it will open up the material browser. Let's create a new material, rename it white override, and then click here to open up the Azure library, and then go to appearance library, and here we'll choose a plastic material. Just click plastic, and then I want to use this ABS white. Let's load this in, and then we'll just reduce the reflectance. Just make it 0.1 and then click OK. Now we can just copy this material name and paste it on the other layers. So let's select the material name and then Control C and just paste that here on the door frame. Just delete this first and then Control V, and we will repeat it with the other layers which we want to override the material. Now if you notice here, we have a material here for the glazing, for the curtain wall glazing. So we want to apply a glass material to this layer. So let's just type glass here. The reason why I just type the material name here is because this glass material is loaded into a project by default. You can see that here. So whatever material is loaded in your material browser, you can just type the name of that here. So let's do that. Now for the wall, we can just paste the material name. And then we have building paths, and then topography, and we have the lighting equipments, but I don't think the lighting will be visible from outside, but still let's just override that material as well. And then we have plants and the stairs. Now click apply, click OK. There you go. If I change the visual style to realistic, it will look just amazing. Now if you notice here, we have still some materials which did not override. So let's open up the object styles again. Maybe some layers we are missing. So go to imported objects, just click this plus icon, and then I think this one, this is the generic models. I think this yes, this model was created using the model in place. So the name of that model in place component is visible here as generic models. So we can just override that as well. Perfect. Now let's do a quick rendering. First, let's adjust the crop settings. Just click here to show the crop region. And then just adjust the crop region. And just open up the rendering dialog box. And then here I will go for the medium at 600 dpi. It's not going to take too much time because it's only a single material. It should render within 5 minutes, I guess, if you go for high render settings. Now let's click render. So the rendering is now finished, and you can see we got this cool looking white mode rendering in Revit. Now I will share with you another method which is done by using the Enscape, which is a lot more easier. So let's close this and go back to our project. So the Enscape has this cool feature to create the white mode renderings, and for that you don't need to do anything in your Revit project. Just run the Enscape. So the Enscape is now started. Now first let's set up the camera. So I will just change the view style to orthographic, and let's just zoom in a bit. And then to override the materials, we can open up the visual settings. By the way, if you want to watch the Enscape and Revit tutorials, you can check out the link in the description. I did around 30 plus videos on Enscape and Revit. Anyway, to create the white mode rendering, we can just go here in the style, click this drop down and select white. There you go. We got this white mode rendering here. Of course, we can do the changes in the settings here. First, I want to add the outlines around 8% maybe, or let's increase it a bit more. And then we can increase the exposure. I think we need to increase the outlines a bit more. Perfect. Now we can go to atmosphere and increase the sun brightness a bit. And then reduce the shadow sharpness, and go to image and reduce the shadows, and lower the saturation, and increase the color temperature. Perfect. Let's make the lens flare 0 as well as bloom, and then go back to main. We will add a little exposure again, and then increase the rendering quality to ultra, and then go to output and make it ultra HD. And set the file format JPEG or whatever you like. I will select JPEG, and then export this rendering. And the shortcut to export the rendering is Shift plus F11. Let's save that here. So these were the methods I wanted to share with you regarding the overriding materials in Revit. So that's it for this video. I hope you have learned something new. So please make sure to like and share this video and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Don't forget to turn on the post notifications and don't forget to check out my Revit online courses. You can follow the first link in the description. And yeah, see you guys in the next video.